There used to be a time when covert and espionage organizations used to hire sharpshooters or engineers to make them smaller seeing devices, listening devices, focusing on assassinating some revolutionary leader or government leader. But nowadays, the tactic has changed drastically. Covert organizations nowadays are focusing on mob psychology. Social psychologists are being hired instead of sharpshooters. Human behaviorists are being hired and working for the covert organizations of powerful countries. Religious and cultural expertise are being hired instead of engineers. A little scenario on the side of the main scenario prepares the world community to accept quickly any unpleasant and unexpected event and get on with their lives without feeling much guilt. Under the complex plan of dehumanization of Iranian people, like dressed in unpleasant looking material, men with unshaved facial hair, women wrapped in dark colored veils or chadors, and those Islamic dresses, one can effortlessly detect the purpose. Yes, the mass of misled and ignorant people caught in mob madness, chanting death to America, death to Israel, and don't really mean it, since it's part of the everyday drill. Do they deserve death just because they are chanting those slogans? That looks like, in the eyes of the world community, something that can be easily forgotten. Yes, the Shiite folks burned the effigy of Omar, the second caliph of Islam, and cursed the first one, Abu Bakr, and the third one, Osman. Yes, the mass of misled and ignorant people of Iran, caught in mob madness, keep chanting death to America, death to Israel, but not really meaning it, because it's the part of the everyday drill. But does that mean that the world community should have no guilty feeling once those people were annihilated in some God knows what kind of attack, nuclear attack? Yes, the Shiite folks who mainly reside in Iran burn the effigy of Omar, the second caliph of Islam, for the past 500 years. Yes, they curse the first caliph, Abu Bakr, the third caliph, Osman. But burnings of effigies and cursing as a tradition, would it be enough excuse for the Arab world, the Sunni world, to watch those people burn throughout a nuclear attack easily? Is that the plan, gentlemen? Let's be realistic. It all looks that way. Covert organizations of the powerful are playing psychology game. A scenario beautifully written about 50 years ago. A play with perfect cast and crew. and executed like a well-choreographed ballet. Execution of destruction of Iran, the largest country in the Middle East, just because of its faith and religion. No, it's not going to happen. We will not let you do this. The world is not that ignorant. When 9/11 occurred, no one, to the last minute, even thought about it. No scholar in related fields ever foreseen it. Even Ben Barber in his legendary Jihad versus Macworld did not see it coming. But this time the world community can relate to the Al-Qaeda attacks anywhere on the world. Pretty much the same way. So they're going to shrug shoulders if Al-Qaeda attacked some major country like Iran with major arsenal and say, oops, they did it again. So the element of surprise is not a surprise anymore. That is the behind reason for the surprise attack on 9/11. The next attack will also be a surprise out of nowhere. We're going to have breakfast in the morning and watching the news of some missiles being fired towards central Iran. The same way that planes hit the World Trade Center. Same way that planes hit Pentagon. The same way that those poor passengers in those planes were phoning their loved ones through their cell phones and telling these are the last moments of their lives and how much they love them. Those dramatic scenarios are going to be repeated with the people of Iran, notifying that they have 2 hours to live. Because some missiles with some nuclear warheads are flying towards them. A city of millions of people have little time to flee. People are going to get on their cell phones, cry, talk to their relatives, talk to their friends abroad, saying goodbye. Very similar to what happened to those people in 9/11. But this time, the attacks are going to be much larger. The casualties will mount to millions. But it is not going to be a surprise because it has happened before. What a play, gentlemen, you wrote. It's time to stop this plot. Scrap this plot. We know now what is going to happen. Iran will not stand this humiliation under any government or any regime. The Iranian people are proud people. And you know that. And in order to control that region, you must kill them. As the legendary poet Ferdowsi once said, چو ایران نباشد تن من مباد. بدین بوم و بر زنده یک تن مباد. Are we going to make use of that poem? No, you're not. I know you're getting there, but it must be stopped.